I know.
Versus Revit versus SketchUp. Which design software is better? Whether you're an architect, student, or freelance designer, this honest review breaks down what each tool does, how they compare in real projects, their pros and cons, and which one you would pick for different scenarios. Be sure to watch to the very end so that you can pick out which software is best suited for you. So let's start with Rhino. Rhino is a powerful 3D modeling tool known for its freeform modeling capabilities. It's a favorite for industrial designers, product designers, and architects who want to create complex organic shapes that other CAD design tools struggle with. Rhino's strength is precision. It's built for NURBS modeling, which means smooth, mathematically accurate curves and surfaces with exact mathematical accuracy. Beyond industrial and architectural design, Rhino is huge in jewelry, product, and marine design too. Anywhere you need custom, fluid forms. Its open architecture means you can expand it endlessly with plugins like Grasshopper for parametric design or even script your own tools. Rhino is like a blank canvas for designers who want total creative freedom. Next, Revit. Revit is Autodesk's flagship BIM software, building information modeling, designed mainly for architects, engineers, and construction professionals. Unlike Rhino, Revit isn't just for modeling shapes. It's about creating intelligent, data-rich 3D building models that link drawings, schedules, and documentations all in one place. This makes Revit perfect for producing coordinate plans, sections, and schedules automatically as you model. Its real-time collaboration lets architects, structural, and MEP engineers work in one central model, which massively reduces coordination errors. Revit also integrates well with other Autodesk products, making it the backbone for many big firm workflows. If you need detailed drawings and project documentation, Revit is the industry standard. And next, SketchUp. SketchUp is famous for being easy to learn and lightning fast for quick conceptual design. It's often the first tool architects and designers pick up because it feels intuitive, like sketching on paper but in 3D. The simple push-pull modeling lets beginners experiment freely without worrying about complex commands. With SketchUp, you can go from a blank screen to a simple building concept in minutes, which is why it's great for client pitches or quick feasibility studies. It also has the massive 3D warehouse, where you can drag and drop pre-made furniture, plants, cars, anything you need to dress up your model. While it can't match Rhino's precision or Revit's BIM depth, SketchUp's speed and simplicity make it a perfect first step in any project. Many pros still start in SketchUp, then move into Rhino or Revit for the heavy lifting. And now for the feature comparisons. For this scenario, we have broken down each feature into modeling style, best for, collaboration, etc. In terms of modeling style, Rhino is freeform, while Revit has parametric BIM modeling. SketchUp has direct 3D sketching and push-pull modeling. Rhino is best for complex geometry and organic shapes. Revit for building design documentation and BIM. And SketchUp for concept design and fast visualizations. In terms of collaboration, Revit is the winner here, as it has a strong multi-user collaboration. With plugins and extensions, Revit has many BIM libraries and MEP and structure as well. Rhino has Grasshopper and many plugins for workflows. SketchUp has a 3D warehouse with lots of user-made content. In terms of ease of learning, SketchUp wins here as it is the easiest for beginners. Revit has a moderate learning curve, while Rhino has a steeper learning curve. In terms of rendering and visualization, Revit has built-in 3D views and works with landscape. SketchUp has ED rendering plugins like Lumia, while Rhino needs plugins like V-Ray. In terms of price, SketchUp wins here as it has a free version and a pro subscription if you like. Revit is subscription-based only, and Rhino has a one-time license or subscription. And now for the pros and cons. Rhino has incredible modeling freedom. Rhino lets you create any form imaginable, from tiny product details to huge urban master plans. Its precision means your final model is as accurate as your imagination. Perfect for bespoke design. Extensive plugin ecosystem. Grasshopper alone transforms Rhino into a parametric powerhouse, and plugins for rendering, analysis, and fabrication make it super flexible. The community is active too. You'll find tons of user-made scripts and support online. One-time license option. You can buy Rhino outright instead of paying forever. This makes it budget-friendly for freelancers and studios who want to own their tools long-term. However, it doesn't have any true BIM features. Rhino doesn't handle smart building elements or construction documentation on its own. You often need to combine it with Revit or plugins for real-world building projects. It is a steep learning curve. While basics are quick to learn, mastering advanced NURBS modeling or grasshoppers takes serious time. Many beginners get overwhelmed without training. Limited built-in collaboration. Rhino doesn't have native multi-user workflows like Revit's central model. Teams need plugins or careful file management to avoid version conflicts. And now for Revit. Revit has industry-standard BIM. If you work with buildings, Revit's parametric modeling and integrated documentation are hard to beat. You can manage every detail, from floor plans to cost schedules, in one file. Multidisciplinary collaboration. Architects, structural engineers, and MEP pros can all edit the same model live. This cuts down on clashes and change order headaches during construction. Strong documentation tools. As you build your 3D model, drawings and schedules update automatically. This saves huge amounts of time compared to manual drafting. However, it has less flexible geometry. For truly organic or sculptural forms, Revit struggles. Many designers model wild shapes in Rhino, then import them. It has high hardware demands. Revit can eat up RAM and processing power, especially on big commercial projects. Be ready to invest in a solid workstation. And lastly, it has subscription-only pricing. There's no perpetual license. You're locked into Autodesk's yearly or monthly fees. For small studios or freelancers, this can add up quickly. And now for SketchUp. SketchUp has a fast learning curve. Its simplicity means anyone can start modeling on day one. It's great for students, hobbyists, and professionals who need speed. It is great for early stage design. Quickly test ideas, massing, and client concepts before moving into heavy BIM or detail CAD. It's ideal for fast feedback rounds. It has a huge model library. The 3D warehouse gives you instant access to thousands of free objects. This saves time and makes your models look polished with minimal effort. However, it has limited precision for details. SketchUp can handle basic geometry well, but complex construction details or parametric elements can get messy. For final construction documents, you'll likely need another tool. It has basic documentation tools. Layout helps export drawings, but it's nowhere near Revit's level for BIM documentation. It's best for simple presentation sets. It can get cluttered. Heavy files and too many plugins can slow SketchUp down fast. Organizing layers and groups properly is key to keeping it manageable. And now for the real-world scenarios. For scenario 1, designing an organic pavilion, Rhino handles complex curves and organic panels effortlessly. Revit helps document the structure once the form is final, and SketchUp works for quick massing but struggles with precision curves. For scenario 2, coordinating a large commercial building, Revit is the clear winner for full BIM workflows, detailed drawings, and clash detection. Rhino can support unique facade elements or custom interiors, and SketchUp might help for concept massing before moving it to Revit. For scenario 3, pitching an idea to a client fast, SketchUp is unbeatable for quick mockups, simple visuals, and easy edits. Rhino can refine unique design elements if needed, and Revit works if the project is moving straight to construction docs. So which one is the best? For freeform, complex shapes, Rhino wins. For serious architecture, BIM, and construction documentation, Revit is the clear winner here, as it is the industry standard. SketchUp stays king for quick concepts or client pitches for speed and simplicity. The truth is, many designers use two or all three together. Pick what fits your projects and your budget. So which design tool are you using daily? Let us know in the comments. And if you found this review helpful, hit that like button and subscribe for more honest reviews. And see you in the next honest comparison.